Katrina's hypocrisy is the story of the day.
I have never personally lobbied, ever.
Katrina Sweat and Annie Custer are clashing over the dark political territory of lobbying. Both women have connections to the industry, but each is eager to pin the lobbying label on the other.
Until she defends or explains her role that she's lied about in the past as a lobbyist for a Wall Street firm, she's got a company called Katrina Sweat's Associates. Until she comes clean on her record, I'm just going to stay focused on what the voters want to talk about.
Sweat's name is listed on a lobbying registration form from the 1990s that refers to her as the vice president of her husband's lobbying firm.
The company that my husband and I had, he had two clients, and on the paperwork, every principal in the office was listed, basically out of an overabundance of caution, but I never personally lobbied.
Previously, Sweat compared her situation to a voter who is registered to vote but doesn't ever cast a ballot. Friday, she used a new analogy.
Well, I guess it's kind of like the Selective Service. You know, you register for the Selective Service, but that doesn't make you a soldier.
Before launching her campaign, Custer had been a lobbyist for nearly 20 years.
And I think she's conflicted about a number of her lobbying clients. She's had some very good clients, but she's also been a lobbyist for the pharmaceutical industry, insurance companies, the financial industry.
I think Katrina Sweat can spend this entire campaign, if that's what she chooses to do, making accusations and trying to disguise her own record as a federal lobbyist in Washington. I'm way focused on the issues with voters.
Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.